Hello everybody. I'm not talking about one thing that is very useful for those who need the plots to be used in any other file. So let's say you have a plot like what we have here. I already did all the plotting and formatting and everything, and you all know how to do this if you watched the previous videos. But the point now is that I have to put this, let's say, in a report or in a paper or something like that. And I need it to be in a good quality or a good quality image, and don't know how to do this. So the first thing that might jump in your mind is that I'm going to go here and then save as, and Matlab will open the folder that is the default folder in the here, which is this the current folder. And I would say call it sine cosine, and you'd see that the format is .fig, which is MATLAB figure. So I would save it, and let's say you open this folder, you would find that this image kind of doesn't have a software that can open it. And if you go back to MATLAB, then you would see that this same file is here, but you can open it. So I would close the file, the figure, and I would double click on this, and it will open the same figure. So this, the figure is saved as a MATLAB image that can be edited in the future. You can open the same thing with the property editor and do all the formatting in this file format. And let's say I even delete the X, Y, and Z that I used to plot these and reopen this, it's already saved. So it's saved as data in MATLAB, even if the original data are deleted. I cannot use this as an image that's used in documents is JPEG images, PNG, TIF, whatever format. So to do this, you need to save as, and then you choose the file format that you want. They are all available, TIF, you can use PNG, even PDF, you can use JPG, BMP, FIG. The most familiar or the most widely used one is the JPG, and I will save. And it's done. Actually, if you open the folder, you will find this file here. I'm opening it now. The file is a JPEG image that can be inserted now in any software like PowerPoint or Word or something. But the issue with this image is that it is a very, very poor resolution image. If you take a closer look, you'd see all the lines are pixelated, and even the text doesn't look like a good image. And this is an issue with the resolution, actually, and to be able to fix it, you have to go back to this image and do some setup for the exporting that you're doing. And that's why you need to go to the export setup. And once you go here, you'll find some options here. This is related more to the size of the image. I'm not going to play with it. The point that makes a very big difference regarding the formatting or the resolution of the image is what we call the resolution here. So it's the automatic, I don't know what's the auto resolution, which is, I think it's the screen resolution, which is not a good thing. And you can increase it to 300, 600, whatever thing. I put it to the maximum just to see the difference. One more option here is that you can change the color space, RGB or grayscale, CMYK, or anything. I prefer RGB. I would go for this last thing, which is the custom color, which is the color of the background. You can change it in the formatting, but you can change it here. I will apply this to the figure, and then the background is white. And most of people like to put this so that it's good looking in the documents when you put it in there. You can do some stuff with the fonts and lines. I'm not going to play with them now. And now I'm ready to export, so I'm going to export. Scott is the file name, I'll make it sine cosine 2, and it's now exporting. Of course, as the resolution increases, it will take more time to export the figure, but once it's done, you don't need to worry about anything. So it's done now, you can close this window. I'm going to go back to this folder, and now we need to take a look at the difference between these two files and the sizes of the two files. This is 102 kilobytes, and this is 1.8 megabytes. Of course, it's a huge file. Usually, you don't need to go that big, but this is because I used 600 DPI. And I would just open the two images. This is the old, and this is the new. And let's zoom in here and see how the lines look as you get closer. I'm getting really close now. I don't know how much percent is the increase or the zooming in, but I'm zooming, I think it's 600-700%. And you're getting closer and closer, and the image is very, very sharp and good. And this is totally different from what we saw before. So it's very, very useful to have good quality images for your files. So all what you need to do is just to adjust the resolution. And this is mainly everything is that you can do. And don't forget the saving as FIG. It's very, very useful, especially if the image is going to be used in the future. Let's say you put it in a paper and then you don't like it and you need or send it to somebody else and he gave you some advice that you need to change the image or do some edits to the image. As soon as you have this file saved, you can do anything. You don't have to start over from the beginning. Otherwise, you have to go for the image from the very beginning, which is, from my personal experience, is a very, very painful process. You spend some time working on it. You have to save it so you don't need to work or to repeat the same work again. So that's all for today, and I'll see you next video. Goodbye.